So let's see how Frontier can help us quickly make changes to an existing web application. So over here, I have a web application that's built using React. I'm using ShadCN for the UI components. I'm using Tailwind for the styles, and I'm also using TypeScript. And it's a pretty complex application. You can see here that in the Anima Frontier extension, I've got 250 plus local components that I've defined. And I'm also pulling in over 100 external components. And this is running using Vite. So let's just have a quick look at what this site looks like in action. So the site I have over here is a suite of different ShadCN components. And then I have some more contextual examples. So you can see we have this music page, we have this authentication page, and we've got this forms page as well that has a bunch of inputs and a couple of buttons. So back in the code here, I have this component open, and this component corresponds with that form page that you just saw. And so we're going to be building off this page. So the designer in our team has pinged me saying that the Figma file has some more changes, and they've sent me over the link. So I'm just going to go over and copy the link they've sent me and put it into Frontier. So now we've linked our design to our code base. I'm going to go ahead and look, and I spotted this little green indicator that suggests that this particular page is ready for dev. So I'm going to go and click the form screen, and you can see if we zoom in over here that this is pretty much the form screen that I demoed a moment ago, except it's got a few more inputs up here. So we're going to use Frontier to quickly implement the updated designs. And so already Frontier has generated a bunch of code for us, and I'm just going to scroll down, and at the bottom here you can see that we've got the like URLs inputs, and we've also got the text area inputs as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy the code down to the update profile button and paste it in here. And we get a couple of errors. So let's have a look at what's going on here. So it just looks like we haven't imported these components. So I'm going to go ahead and import this label. I'm also going to import this text area. And so we don't have any more errors anymore. So I'm going to go back to the browser, and great, you can see that the components have been added pretty much according to the design. So there's a couple of things that I've noticed. Actually, in fact, the only thing I've noticed is that this label doesn't quite look identical to the other labels in the page, and clicking it doesn't focus the text area. So let's just quickly make that change ourselves. So the first thing I'm going to do is just understand why this label looks different. And I can see that the component that it is using is different from the rest of the labels. So I am actually going to go ahead and change this to form label. And now if I jump back in, you can see that it looks pretty spot on. And then I'm also going to associate the label to a form input so we get that good focus behavior. So I'm just going to call it text area, and I'm going to give this an ID of text area. Looks like I've done something wrong. So let's go ahead and fix that. Great, so if we jump back here and I click this, we get the focus behavior. So that's great. So thanks to Frontier, I'm able to quickly update my UI using the code that it generates. And this frees me up to implement some more complex interactions myself. Like for instance, we have this list of inputs, and maybe we'd want to dynamically add another one if someone clicks this add URL button. So I hope this video has shown you how Frontier can fit inside your developer workflow to help speed up your UI development.